Hello everyone. Today I'm going to explain how to do Arduino based projects online using Tinkercad software. And here in this particular video, I'm going to explain a simple project that is blinking of different LEDs based on delay sequence. That means if one LED is on, another LED will be off. So it will operate in this sequence continuously. So let us see this example. So to do this, first we need to open this tinkercad.com website, and then you need to log in with your Gmail ID. Then this dashboard window will be appeared. So on the left side, you can clearly observe there will be different icons like 3D design, circuits, code blocks, lessons, etc. So whatever you want to do in this, you can select. Suppose if you want to design any 3D architectures, so you can select this. So but we are doing circuits, so I'm selecting circuits. In that, there will be different already completed projects will be displayed. So if you want to create new thing, so create new circuit, click on this. Then an empty window will be opened along with different components on the right side. So when you observe on the right side, so there will be different components like resistors, LEDs, capacitors, sensors, Arduino board, breadboard, etc. Okay. So first thing is, you can drag and drop here in this empty window, editor window, in order to create your circuit. Suppose I'm doing Arduino based circuit. So just I'm dragging and dropping the Arduino board here. Okay. So it will be appeared like this. So just I'm rotating this in order to display properly. So to do the Arduino projects, first of all, you should know about these digital pins. All these pins are nothing but output pins. And these analog 6 pins are nothing but input pins. Okay. So whatever the output devices you can connect here. And this sign wave symbol for some particular pins, you can use it as a digital output or analog output. Okay. And there will be some power supplies and grounds. So if you are going to do any Arduino based project, first of all, you should have clear idea about pin configurations. So for this example, it is very simple thing you need to understand is, so these are the output pins. Since we are working based on LEDs, since LED is a output device, so it will display the light only. It will produce light. We cannot take the input from LED. So we understand that LED must be connected to any of these pins. Clear? So for the connection purpose, I am taking breadboard, just dragging and dropping here so that it will appear. So for this breadboard, based on the breadboard, I'm doing the here. Take an LED and connect in the breadboard. Just leave here. Automatically, it will connect to 2 pins. So I think you all know about breadboard connections. All vertical lines are same points. So for the ground purpose, I'm connecting one line. So just click on this and drag a line and connect to the ground pin here, so that this line entirely will be considered as ground. Now I'm connecting this cathode pin to the ground, and the anode pin is connected to output pin of Arduino through a proper resistance. You can change the value of the resistance. So just giving this to some 220 ohms. So you can give any value based on that silver. So this resistance is connected to, suppose I'm connecting to 13 pin. If you connect to 13 pin, since 13th pin is the default LED pin in the Arduino, so by default, some program will be displayed. If you connect like this, automatically some code, some default code will be displayed in terms of blocks. If you don't have any knowledge regarding programming syntax, so you can go through these blocks. So connect these blocks as per the sequence, so that the program automatically will be created in the text. So instead of blocks, if there are text here, automatically you can clearly observe this real-time Arduino program. So automatically it will be displayed. No need to write any lines. Since I am connecting to 13th pin, so in the pin mode, instead of 13, by default it is displayed as LED built-in, because the built-in pin for LED is 13 in Arduino. So if you start simulating this, That means if you click on run, so automatically the LED will blink. So it will blink on and off. Since we are giving some delay here, so when the LED is on, I means on, and wait for 1000 milliseconds, that is 1 second, and again it will be off. So it will continue. For example, if you don't connect this to default pin, then what will happen? Since I am connecting this to another pin, let it be 7th pin. Okay, 7th pin. Now if you start simulating, then you won't get any outputs. So the LED will not be displayed because this is not the default pin. Since that is, output is not displayed. So what to do is, go to the code. Instead of giving bulletin, LED bulletin, you need to mention that pin number. What is the pin number? 7th pin. So pin mode low. In the pin mode, we need to give 7th pin as the output. Similarly, wherever it appears, you can change this to 7th. 7th pin, and here also 7th. So automatically, it will be adjusted. And if you click on run, then automatically, now the LED will operate as usual, even though we are connecting to different pins. Now, I'm going to do is, I'm connecting another LED. I'm connecting another LED here. So let me change the color of the LED. So instead of red, let it be green. Okay. And then again, the resistance. Connect the resistance. Let's move this way. So connect the resistance here, as like we've done in previous case. Again, change the value of the resistance to 70 to 20. Make it 1 kilo as it is also, it will be run, no problem. Now I am connecting this second LED to any of the other pin. So let it be 4th pin. Okay, 4th pin. And this must be connected to again ground. So this is the common ground. Now let us see. Okay, so if you run this code, because we already modified the code in only for 7th pin. So if you start simulating, only that will be simulated. Only first LED will turn on. There is no operation on second LED because there is no code updation here. So because we already have modified that code as only for 7th. Similarly, here I am modifying this as, okay. So 7th pin is output. Similarly, we connect LED to 4th pin also. So let it be 4th pin is also output pin. Then in this line indicates that 7th pin LED should be high. So when one LED is on, automatically other LED should be off. So let it be 4th pin LED must be turn off. Turn off means you can give it as low. Now wait for 1 second. Then automatically 7th pin LED should be off and 4th pin LED should be on. Again, wait for 1 second so that it will repeat. So I am modified the code, then I am start simulating. Then you can clearly observe. So when this red LED on, automatically this will be off. When this is on, it will be off. Okay. So in order to clearly observe, you can change the delay also. You can change the delay. Instead of 1000, you can take 2000 so that you can observe here delays. Okay, now I'm start running. So this is on, so this is off. After 2 seconds, this is on and this will be off. Again, after 2 seconds, this is on and this will be off. So it will keep on simulating based on our programming or logic. Okay, here if you don't know this particular syntax, so select block here. In that block, you can change these blocks according to your requirement. Or if you understand this, what I am saying in this video, so you can directly go to these lines, you can change the lines accordingly. Okay, so this is the previous code, it will display, no problem. So that's it. Okay, I hope if you want to continue this kind of projects, or a sequence of LEDs. So you can connect more number of LEDs and change the logic in the code so that different LEDs will keep on turning on and off sequentially according to your requirement. So I hope this video will be very useful for you in order to for beginners to start programming and doing projects based on Arduino online. So here without hardware device also and without programming knowledge also you can able to do this. So the same thing will be implemented when you buy a hardware for Arduino and you can connect real components and you can copy paste this code in your real Arduino software, right? So thank you very much.